What's up, everybody? Welcome back to my channel and welcome to another video. So I've been getting so many questions every time I post a denim look on my Instagram that I thought I would do a collective try on haul sharing with you guys my entire denim collection. I absolutely love, love, love denim, and I feel like denim is my go-to. Like 9 times out of 10, I will reach for a pair of shorts or a pair of jeans to style my daily outfits. And I know a lot of you really enjoy the videos that I do when I share denim that it's out there from different stores, but I want you guys to know the ones that I have that I absolutely love and continuously go through my wardrobe, pick them out to style my daily outfits. So I do hope that you guys enjoy this video, and let's get started. Some of you are starting summer right now, whereas here in the UK we're leaving summer. However, in the next couple of days we're going to have a heat wave, so shorts will definitely come out. The first ones that I want to talk about are my Levi's 501 shorts. I can't remember the name, but I'll make sure to link them below. These are the distressed ones, and they have kind of like a, they're not jet black, they're kind of like a washed black. These retail for £50 full price, but I got them half price. And the size that I have here is size 28 waist, and they are a button fly. What I love about these, not only they're 100% cotton, but the denim is not very rigid. So it definitely allows a little bit, I wouldn't say room, but the denim will mold to your body. Now with Levi's, for those of you who are new here, I usually buy a size 29, but I also have a pair of Levi's 501 jeans, which I'll be talking about in a minute. I bought those in a size 28 because the 29 was a little bit too big. However, with shorts, I highly recommend either you stick to your actual size or to go up a size, because I find with denim shorts it looks a little bit more roomy, if that makes any sense. Now these ones, I tend to wear them more for dress down days, if I'm going with my daughter to the park, if I was to go to the beach, which I didn't this year, but if I was, I would more than likely wear these because I find that they're very relaxed. I wouldn't wear these to kind of like go out, because when I'm walking they rise a little bit on the leg, maybe because I should have bought the size 29, but they were sold out, but they still fit me really nicely and I absolutely love them. Next we have a pair of Mum Fit Bermuda shorts from Zara. These ones retail for £19.99 and I got them in size 12. They come in 4 different shades, but I decided to buy the lighter blue shade. They're super high-waisted and they look very vintage. Now one thing I love about these shorts is the length. You can wear them rolled up, but I prefer to wear them rolled down. I feel like they suit my style and my aesthetic a lot better. I love pairing them with high heels, with a blazer, with a bodysuit, with trainers. They're very, very versatile, and they're a little bit more dressy than the previous ones because there's not a lot, like there's no distress down here, but there is a little bit of distressing on the top. I love them. I find them very versatile, and as I mentioned, because they're a little bit more dressy, there's no distressing anywhere. You can wear them for more. You have more choices of how to style this and for different settings as well. You could definitely wear these to go to work. If your environment at work is not super dressed up, like for myself, I can wear shorts if I want to the office. So these would be a good option, and they give a really nice feminine vibe. Okay, so moving along to the next shorts. These ones are also by Levi's and they are 501s. They're very similar to the black ones. They have a little bit of distressing here, a frayed hem, and they look like this on the back. Now, Levi's shorts, I believe they all retail for around £50, but I got these on promotion the same time, so I only paid £25. They have a button fly, which is the normal kind of like thing for Levi's, and I love them. Now, these I got in size 29 because the 28 was sold out, and I'm really happy I chose the 29 because I feel like these ones fit me a lot nicer. I don't know. They fit similar, but they fit a little bit more comfortable. I love both of them. I just love blue denim. I feel like it's the vintage look and vibe that everybody goes for. I feel like these are so versatile for the entire year. Obviously, depending where you live, in the winter, I wouldn't be wearing shorts. But if I was to travel to a warm climate, for sure, I would be picking these. Again, I find that with these, I can dress them up, dress them down. Maybe you wouldn't wear these ones to go to work, but I would definitely wear them for a night out with heels, with trainers, and a nice blazer. They are so pretty, and I'm super happy that I got these because, I don't know, I really love the tone of this blue, and the distressing is not too overwhelming, which means that you have a piece that is a little bit more versatile in your wardrobe. And my last shorts are the weekday dandy shorts. They are kind of like the Bermuda short style. They're a little bit longer than any of the previous three that I showed. I got these in a size 10 or 38, and they retail for £35. I love weekday denim. Like, these ones are very, very similar in texture to the Levi's, and they are as well 100% cotton. Now, I decided to size down in these because I remember trying the size 12 and I felt like they were a little bit too baggy for me. They're a lot, they're very high-waisted compared to the other ones, maybe similar to the Zara ones, but they're very high-waisted. And out of the four, I feel like these ones are the most dressy ones just because the length is a little bit longer. So definitely suitable for different settings. And again, if you can wear shorts to go to work, then these ones are not too short. They're perfect. I remember some of you asking me about these and you bought them and you absolutely love them. They come in two different shades. I think they also have them in black, like a washed out black, but they didn't have them in my size anymore. Again, because they are a little bit more dressy, I can wear them with a linen shirt, with a bodysuit, with a blazer. They're very, very versatile and I absolutely love them. So I don't currently own a denim jacket, which is something that I should really be adding onto my wardrobe. However, I haven't found the right one, but I found this really nice shirt recently in Zara. This is current season and this is as thick as a denim jacket. Now, because it's a shirt, I feel like it gives a different vibe. So you can wear it outside or you can actually tuck it in to jeans. And I've done a denim on denim look very recently, and this is the shirt that I was wearing. So again, because it's super thick, it's almost like a denim jacket. It gives you a little bit of warmth. It's oversized. I love the shade and I got it in size medium. I believe this one retails for £25.99. I wish that the buttons were in silver, but that is just personal preference. I like things to be maybe rose gold or gold or even kind of like a rusty brown. I really like that, but I don't mind it. It still goes really well with my outfits, and I love doing denim on denim looks, and I feel like this works so well. It's very thick, like I mentioned before, so definitely you can wear this as a jacket and not just as a shirt, like a layering piece. And it was super affordable. It's made of organic cotton. I think it's from their Joint Life, and again, I got this in a size medium. So now moving along to denim trousers. The first ones are my Ribcage in a dark wash. These ones are a 29 waist and 29 in seam, and I love these. This wash is so perfect for the upcoming season. Now, I'm very new to Ribcage, but I have three pairs here that I'm going to show you guys, and I bought all three on promotion. One thing I need to stress in this video, if you buy Levi's, never buy them full price because there's always discounts coming up every now and again. And I bought these ones in particular for 50% off, so I only paid £46. I love these. They're very, very like super high waist. That's why they're called Ribcage. And these ones are the straight leg rib cage. Buttonfly again, which is typical and very, very nice. Another thing I want to mention about the sizing of rib cage. I've seen videos before I bought these and a lot of people were saying that you need to size down. I feel like you need to try them on to see how you feel. These are not the most comfortable jeans if you're going to size down and you want to wear them for your day to day. You will not feel comfortable if you work in an office and you have to sit the entire day. That's a no-no. And that's the reason why I tried them in store and I felt like the 29 was fine. It does differ with the shades, but I'll get to that in a minute. With these ones, I tried the 28 and they were so tight I could barely breathe. So the 29 fits perfectly and I love them. You'll notice throughout the video that I'm not going into any particular order, as in brand for brand. I'm going by their wash. It makes a little bit more sense for me. I don't know why, but I'm going to jump now to a pair of jeans from Zara. These are the authentic 1975 slouchy jeans and they look like this. A lot of you absolutely love these jeans. Every time I post these on my Instagram, I get so many likes and you guys really love them. They were a great, great buy. Now this wash is no longer available on their website and I don't even think they have any slouchy jeans at the moment, but I paid £25.99, got them in size 12 and they have just a little bit of distressing on the knee. They taper at the bottom and they look like this on the back. I absolutely love this style. I can dress them up, dress them down, add a belt, a nice bodysuit, a blazer, and I'm ready to go. And I look really dressed up, if that makes any sense. Although they're just a simple, like in a certain way, they are simple, but they are very unique at the same time. And I really love the slouchy jean. Now, these ones are a little bit, they have like a slight amount of stretch and I feel like I could have even gone down one more size, but the size 12 fits perfectly fine. And again, I can dress them up in so many different ways. They're super versatile and I will continue to wear these ones in the winter months. So these ones right here are also from Zara and they have to be my most worn denim in my collection. These are the classic mom fit ripped jeans because these ones have ripped on the knees and they look like this on the back. These ones also retail for £25.99. And they have released three shades. One is very similar to this one. And then they have lighter washes as well, which I will link for you guys below. Size that I have is size 12 UK. And I love them. One of the things that I love about them is how high-waisted they are. But then they kind of like taper at the bottom. They don't look super tight on me, which is something that I love about this particular mom jean style. I prefer these ones to the original ones, although the original ones are very, very nice. And when I mean the original, I'm still talking about Zara. I just love that these ones have a little bit more character. I love the shade. The rips are just getting bigger and bigger. More than likely by next year, I may not even have these little parts here that are attaching from one side to another. I just love them. And before I forget, these ones are a zipper fly. And if I've not mentioned the price, they were £25.99. Okay, so moving along to the next ones. These are my 501s ripped straight jeans. I think that's the name. They have rips on the knee and they look like this and from the back. I absolutely love the Levi's tag. This one is kind of like the leather one, which I really like. Size, I got a 28 waist and 28 in seam and they fit me perfectly. A lot of people really love the ribcage jeans, but I feel like you should definitely have a pair of Levi's. They are very, very flattering, especially on the bum. And because the leg is straight, they look very, very flattering for sure. These are like one of my favorite ones in my collection. Sizing, I had to downsize to a size 28 because I felt the 29 was a little bit too relaxed. And like I said, because they're a really nice, almost soft denim, they do mold to your body, but they are 100% cotton. There's no stretch in these ones whatsoever. Whereas the ribcage, if I'm not mistaken, they're 99% cotton and 1% elastane. These ones are 100% cotton. cotton, and they're very comfortable. I can wear them to work. Love dressing them up, dressing them down. They are of a high rise, so they kind of like stop right where my belly button is, and I find them super comfortable. I want to buy another pair exactly the same, but without rips, a little bit more classic. But I feel like you can definitely dress these up, dress them down. It really depends on your style. I have a more kind of like minimalistic, but very casual, smart type of style. So having them with a little bit of rips just adds a little bit more fun to my outfits. And I absolutely love them. Now, when it comes to pricing, again, I got these half price, so I only paid around £45 for them. Next, I have another pair of Levi's ribcage straight leg jeans. These ones are in a lighter or medium blue wash, and they look like this. And the leg is straight, but a lot wider than the 501s. These ones are a button fly, and all the Levi's that I'm going to show you are button fly. If I don't mention, it's just because I keep forgetting. These ones were the most expensive ribcage that I have. I paid for these ones around £68 because they only had like a 25 or 30% off, and I love them. Now, when it comes to sizing, again, I got them in size 29 waist and 29 in seam, but these ones, I don't know why, they're a lot thicker than the other. I think they're very similar in thickness, but these ones stretch a little bit more than the darker rib cage that I showed. They fit really, really good, but I feel like the size 28 would have probably fitted me better. But again, because they're very high waist, sitting down in jeans like that the entire day and I work in an office, it's not the most comfortable thing. So maybe the 29 is perfectly fine, but I feel like I'm in between sizes. I'm in between a 28 and a 29 in this particular shade. But I love the shade. It's perfect for all year round. And when it comes to the rib cage, I style them in so many different ways. They're very, very versatile and very flattering as well because of the high rise or the high waist, because they come up till here. You can style them with a crop top. I wouldn't, not for my body, but with a crop top, I think it would look really nice. A bodysuit, a nice silk shirt and heels. I think it would be a really, really beautiful look. And I love them. Next, I have the last pair of Levi's jeans that I'm going to talk to you guys in this video, and they're also my lightest wash. I've never owned any denim in this shade, and I love them. They're a very, very faint of blue, and I think the name of this shade is very similar to what I'm saying. So they look like this from the front and from the back like this. They have no rips, but they have a frayed hem at the bottom, and I love these are kind of like an elevated look for a off-white or a white or a very, very light shade of blue. Does that make any sense? Like, they're kind of like in between all those shades, but they look very different and they definitely stand out. Now, again, 29 waist and 29 in seam, and they fit perfectly. These ones, I got them half price for £46. So this is what I mean when it comes to Levi's. Always wait for the sales. I mean, if you really, really want them and you can't afford, depending on your budget, then of course go ahead and buy it at full price. But if you are on a budget, then wait for the sales, because there's always discounts at their website and at different partners that they have, like John Lewis here in the UK. They also do promotions on their Levi's. But these ones, again, I style them in so many different ways. My favorite way to style these particular ones is with brown sliders and a bodysuit and a cardigan. That's how I like to style them, or just a t-shirt, and they look amazing and I absolutely love them. And I know you'll be getting annoyed with me saying I absolutely love them, but I genuinely do. These are things that I invested in and I love wearing them. I have two more pieces that I want to show you guys, but now we're going to move on to the lighter spectrum of my collection, and I'm starting with my Zara Authentic 1975 slouchy jeans in this gorgeous creamy shade. These are 100% cotton. There's no stretch to them. Size 12, and they look like this, and they taper a little bit at the bottom. If you follow me on Instagram, you've seen me post several pictures or several looks with these jeans. I really, really love them. They're very versatile again. They're very chic in their own way. And I love wearing these with sliders or with trainers, a little vest, and I'm ready to go. That is something that I really, really like. And the shade, it's not too warm. It's kind of like a cool tone beige almost. And I love them. And again, they're versatile. They're no longer available on the website, unfortunately. I think now the style that Zara has is like the paper bag style, which I'm not a fan of. But I will link below two options. I know one from Massimo Dutti, which is very similar, but made of a really nice material as well. And Mango also has the Regina slouchy jeans, which are very similar to these. So make sure to check the info bar below for that link. Okay, and my last pair of jeans that I have right here, these ones are from Anna the Stories, and these are the straight leg jeans that come in this gorgeous, gorgeous beigey shade. It's kind of like an off-white. They look like this at the bottom. They're straight leg and like this at the back, and they have a zipper fly. Now, these are very similar to a pair of jeans that I had from H&M that a lot of you love. I think they're called the vintage straight leg jeans, which will be linked below. I no longer have those ones because I felt that the 12 was stretching a little bit too much for me. So I decided to invest in one that was a little bit thicker and that the quality was a little bit better. So these ones from Another Stories are very expensive. They cost £65, but I feel when you pay for quality, you definitely get what you're paying for. So these ones, although they have a little bit of stretch in them, the cotton is organic, the cotton is thicker, and they're very, very flattering in my opinion. I really, really love them. Like, I can style these in so many different ways. Again, of course, this type of shade may not be suitable for everybody all year round, but I feel like lighter shades in the winter, colder months, in the winter, colder months, fall, winter, are still very, very wearable. It just depends on your style and, you know, if you feel comfortable wearing lighter shades. I've been wearing these to work. They're so comfortable. They're very similar in thickness to my Levi's 501, no, more the ribcage. I think those ribcage are a little bit thicker, but I really, really love them. And I know they're £65, but worth every single penny. So I guess we've reached the end of this video. I do hope that you guys enjoyed it. And if you did, please comment below letting me know which one of these you like the most, or if you have any options at home which are very, very similar or the same. I would love to know. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, make sure that you do so. And also hit that bell notification, because I've noticed that YouTube is not sending notifications to a lot of you, and a lot of you have brought that to my attention. So make sure to hit that bell notification. I post a video every single week. Thank you so, so much for joining me, and I'll see you on my next one. Bye.